thank you for the invitation here to this event. Thank you for giving us the opportunity to present our project, which was funded as well by the I want to give a presentation about our project on biorefinery on the basis of a starch, rich microalgae biomass. It's a more or less multi-use concept. The aim, the scope of my presentation is the aim of the project. I will present the project partners. We are Fraunhofer, Subitech, and Südzucker Group. Some information on strain selection and process optimization, the scale-up of the process, transfer to outdoor conditions, use of fermentation exhaust gases, and some information on harvest and disruption and characterization of valuable products additional to starch. First, what is a biorefinery? It was said several times today, so I will shorten it up. An integrative, multifunctional overall concept for the conversion of biomass to fuels, power, and chemicals, and to integrate different processes and technology to for complete use of all components of the biomass, and co-products can be for the feed compounds. Here, our biorefinery concept. We want to produce microalgae in flat panel airlift reactors. We want to produce starch-rich biomass, and then we want to separate the starch from the proteins. The starch is converted to bioethanol together in a bioethanol first generation plant. The fermentation of gas consists of 95% to 90% of carbon dioxide, which can be used for algae cultivation. The residual biomass, after separation of starch and proteins, can be converted together with the residual biomass from the first generation bioethanol plant to biogas. So we have the second energy compound here, methane, and the nutrient-rich liquid can be used for growing of the microalgae in the, for the bioreactor. This is our concept, and now the partners. I'm from the Fraunhofer Institute for Spatial Engineering and Biotechnology in Stuttgart, and we have a long-standing experience in algae biotechnology, and we developed this flat panel photobioreactor, and now we have an automatized system for cultivation of different microalgae, and the task in the project was strain selection, optimization of the two-stage starch production process, and the use of the DG state as a nutrient source. The Subitech GmbH is a spin-off of Fraunhofer IGB. They further developed the FBA reactor system, and they are doing the engineering, construction, and commissioning of indoor and outdoor plants based on this technology. And their tasks in the project were use of fermentation exhaust, carbon dioxide, construction and operation of the pilot plants, some growth optimization, and online monitoring of the process. Then, the Südzucker Group, it's a central R&D department in Offstein, near Worms. They use everything which can be done from sugars. and they produce sugar derivatives and bioethanol and some fruit saturations there. The tasks in the project were biomass harvest and disruption and the characterization of valuable ingredients, for example, proteins. Daughter of company of the Südzucker group is Top Energies in Zeitz, in the eastern part of Germany, and it is the largest bioethanol production site in Germany based on grain. That is a first generation energy production. Additional to 300,000 and 60 cubic meters of bioethanol per year, they produce 100,000 tons of liquid food grade carbon dioxide, which is used in some parts for beverages. And additionally, 1 million tons of proteins for food and feed are produced in this production site. The tasks in the project were the provision of infrastructure and fermentation exhaust carbon dioxide for the autopilot plant. And this autopilot plant consists of 24 180-liter reactors located at the production site here in Zeitz. The photobioreactor system we used in this project was a flat panel airlift reactor, and maybe you know it. It's an airlift-driven photobioreactor with different thickness of 3 and 5 centimeters and volume. It has these static mixers. The static mixers creating a very efficient intermixing, and they transport to other cells on the surface of the photobioreactor. And with these static mixers, and we induce a directed fluid flow, and with that we can achieve very high cell concentrations in our photobioreactor. Some pictures. The large-scale reactors at Fraunhofer IGB we used for the strain selection and first process development. Then the outdoor facility at Fraunhofer, it's on the top of our roof, where we transferred the lab results to outdoor conditions. In Zeitz, there was also this 25 liter photobioreactors used for the first experiments, and then we have the outdoor pilot plant there using the exhaust carbon dioxide from the bioethanol plant. Strain selection and process development, we developed a two-stage process. First stage, maximum biomass productivity with optimal nutrient supply, and then we applied nutrient limitation. We tested different limitations to induce starch accumulation. So the composition of the biomass changed from low starch to high starch up to 50%, and the protein content decreased according to the increase of the starch. Strain selection, we tested different strains, and Florella sorokiniana was the best. Within some days, more than 50% of the biomass was starch. It is alpha-1,4 starch, which can be hydrolyzed by commercial enzymes to glucose and then fermented to ethanol. It was one of the requests of Südzucker to produce alpha-1,4 starch. We optimized the starch production first indoors. We tested different kinds of fermentations, nitrogen and phosphate separately or in combination. And the best was nitrogen limitation, and we achieved rather high specific starch productivities up to 25% of biomass content increase the starch per day. And we tested different temperatures and light availabilities. That is, how much light does every single cell get or have to be distributed. And in the lab, we could simply increase the light intensity when the light when the cell biomass increased, but outdoors it's not possible. So therefore, we tested outdoors. We tested different cell concentrations, and within 2 days, the starch content increased up to 50%. This was transferred to the outdoor facility at the Fraunhofer IGB, and here we tested different salt concentrations and the influence on starch content and starch productivity. In all, with different concentrations here from 1.2 to 4.9 gram per liter starch concentration, we achieved up to 40 to 50% of starch. There were no starch losses due to respiration at night. It was very positive. And you see the bars, the gray bars are night, and there is no increase of starch during the night. And we had the highest productivity in the first 2 days after nitrogen depletion. In the meantime, insights. They tested the exhaust gas carbon dioxide from the large bioethanol fermentation and compared it to technical carbon dioxide from bubbles. And there was no difference between the fermentation of gas and the technical carbon dioxide, and we achieved an identical productivity of more than of about 0.6 gram per liter per day. And as you can see here, the biomass concentration in the photobioreactor is rather high, up to 60 gram per liter per day. After 1 year, the pilot plant at Globe Energies was constructed by Subitec. It consists of four lines of these 180-liter FPA reactors with a total volume of 4.5 cubic meters. And with this pilot plant, they installed some online or day online sensors, and an automatic feeding of nutrients was possible. Here are the results of this year cultivation from April to July. Biomass increased up to 12 gram dry weight per liter, and at different times part of the biomass was harvested, and oh, it's red. Can you see? And transferred to the second row, and there the nutrient limitation was applied, and starch-rich biomass could be produced. The productivity was about 0.5 dry weight per liter per day, and in the end, we had enough starch-rich biomass for the upcoming downstream processes. First task of Sitzuka group was compensation of dewatering systems. In short, they tested different centrifuges, a separator and a decanter, and they differ in the achieved biomass concentration. And this one is a discontinuous device, and the other ones are continuous devices, and biomass concentration achieved was quite different. The best one, I think, is the separator from aldehyde. The next step was cell disruption, and here they tested different devices, a ball bearing, different ball bearings, and ultra and high pressure homogenizator, and they tested different parameters, and the results were for ball bearing. The degree of disruption increases with increasing feed filling rate, salt concentration, and agitator speed, and decreases with increasing feed diameter. And in the end, after certification, you can see here the starch, which can be easily separated from the bean residual biomass. Yes. We did some experiments on enzymatic starch liquefaction and ethanol fermentation. So in principle, it's possible to ferment all the starch with a yield of 90% to ethanol. And they looked first at the soluble protein fraction, extracted and precipitated it, and then characterized it, and looked at the technofunctional properties. Like foam properties or foam stability, and currently they are looking on the particulate protein fraction. They do some extraction by pH shift and afterwards precipitation and also characterization. So in summary, we have worked on the different steps of this biorefinery concept. To get fuel, two different fuels, and proteins as a vulnerable component, and reduce some loops between the algae production and first generation biofuel production. So thank you for your attention, and many thanks to the FNR for funding this project. And well, that's a lot. Thank you.